everybody. This is Praxis, and I'm going to be jumping around to show you a bunch of different things today because a lot of things have been going on. First, where we are right here, it's the fireplace hearth. This is where the chimney is going to be. We've decided we have to have a double wall chimney just because of the proximity to things. I've got a quote on that, and it's not bad. It's like $1,700, which may seem crazy, but a lot of that double wall stuff, especially the metal vestas that has to go through the ceiling for the penetration there, can be really expensive. So I was anticipating it might have been more than that. $1,700 sounds just fine to me to get this all done. You can see the tongue oil is all on these rocks. It really brings out the color. The trim is done around here. I also put tongue oil on the bricks below, and I think that really brings out the color. They were kind of dusty, and this makes them look a little better. If you look up in this direction, you can see all the balconies are all done. With the exception of putting some putty in the screw holes, they're structurally sound, they're strong, and I think they came out pretty nicely, so I'm pretty pleased with those. I want to head outside to show you a couple things too. I will note that the kitchen is starting to be functional. There's food in the refrigerator and the cupboards. We're spending whole days here, and I'm able to make lunch for River out of the somewhat functional kitchen. We actually have a bathroom that works in terms of the sink. There is a functioning sink inside, which is handy, and having a toilet is nice too for River, because then I don't have to dump out his bucket, or for myself if I were going to use it. Right over here, a huge pile of lamps. Here, it's all the lamps for the whole house are pre-ordered. It's nice to have them on site because with them being on site, I can measure like the base of the lamp, know what kind of, how big it is, what kind of board it may need to be mounted upon. It's nice to have stuff on site. We also have the oven is on site, but it's not hooked up yet because we still have to work on the electrical stuff. In terms of cooking that we've been doing, I've been using the solar oven right here because the oven, like I said, inside is not hooked up. Also using the parabolic solar cooker here. And realistically, even once we put the solar, regular oven inside, I'm gonna keep using these anyway because it's free energy and it works really well. This thing boils water really quickly. That thing is really great for cooking all sorts of things. We've been doing salmon a couple times in it. Both of these devices work really great. And I'm using the solar hot water cooker every day pretty much just to do create tea, water for tea, because I feel it keeps me hydrated, keeps me going, gets some caffeine in my body, and that keeps me from getting a headache at the end of the day if I'm stressing my body out, which sometimes happens. If I work really hard, I might get a headache, but if I have caffeine in my system, it tends to be, you know, not as much of an issue. Garden over here to your right, it's actually starting to be somewhat functional. Nowhere near as progressed as I would like it, given that I'm recording this in July, but it's something. I got some tomato plants here. I just planted some beans, kind of a late season, mid-season bean crop. Some pumpkins over here. I don't know about that, but you know, I just threw a fistful of seeds in. We'll see what happens. Basil over behind you, and a big pile of compost right there. Well, not that big, actually. It's pretty small. I have ordered 8 cubic yards of compost from the landscape people, but that was almost 2 months ago. I'm not hearing from them, and I'm honestly not that worried about it because I could grab compost out of the woods if I needed it. I'm not worrying about it. It's just, you know, more of the same kind of thing where, you know, people say they're going to do something and they don't do it. But for that, it's not a huge problem, so I'm not stressed over it. Right here, I've got what I'm working on today. These are all of these little channels. These are going to mount to the ceilings. They're going to have lighting fixtures attached to them or smoke detectors attached to them. Cut a hole, put the electrical box in, wires run through here. And all of these are slightly different sizes. In an ideal world, all the beams should be exactly spaced perfectly the same amount from each other, except for the stairs, which are a little wider. But in reality, boards bend, boards twist, and you know, sometimes you make little errors. So I've got a list of all the different widths. They're all labeled A through P. I skipped I because an H looks like an I if you rotate it 90 degrees. So I just skipped over I. And this way, once I get these guys all done, I'll be able to put them up and know exactly where they go because they're all slightly different sizes. I've put these together assembly line style, where I did all the sides, did all the tops, and now I'm about to just sit here in the hot sun and bake while I sand all of them down. That's where things are right now. I think in the next 30 days, we should have the wiring done, and then we can start working on the greenhouse and putting on the wall siding. Lots and lots to do, but things are moving. That's it. Thanks for watching.